According to the American Psychological Association, when infants attach successfully to their parents, they learn to trust the world as a welcoming place and are more likely to explore and interact with their environment. This lays the groundwork for further social, emotional, and cognitive development associated with higher self-esteem and fewer negative outcomes. For these reasons, it is assumed by many parents in family proceedings applying for contact or residence that the courts must recognize the family bond between adult and child. This assumption formed the basis of the reputation of the well-known child psychologist John Bowlby and his best-selling book, Child Care and the Growth of Love, which put forward the concept of monotropy, or the idea that the relationship is hardwired in our DNA. In the United States, Bowlby's work is the foundation for a philosophy of child development described as the circle of security.
Imagine, if you will, a moment in your life in which you felt completely understood. Make it a moment in which your feelings were completely shared by another person who seemed to click on every level of communication with you.
The target audience for the circle of security is parents and their children, and goes on to explain attachment in terms of neurons and their supporting structures.
Alan Shore of the UCLA School of Medicine has stated that we are all hardwired for relationship. Dr. Shore's statement reflects a growing belief in the field of cognitive psychology based on a growing body of scientific research. A belief that explains this feeling of complete understanding and the level of connection, attachment, and relationship that we all seek. The human brain is composed of neurons and their supporting structures, single cells that connect at over 100 billion sites. Much like a computer's circuits, which are turned either on or off to form complex electrical loops and thereby process information, neuronal loops are thought now to form the physical basis of human consciousness and personality.
However, Bowlby's theory that described upbringing in terms of a special adult for every child has since proved wrong, because they may also develop healthily without the input of their natural parents. Indeed, research such as that on refugee children after the Second World War has shown that children can even survive equally well without the help of any adult at all. If this is the evidence, why has Bowlby's reputation achieved such prominence? An answer may lie in the promotional video advertising the circle of security. In the same way that adverts sell the concept behind a product, Bowlby's theory may appeal to our own sense of logic or even pride as parents. The reality is that in order to remain healthy, one of the attributes children need is resilience, and that any caregiver who is sensitive to their needs may fulfill the role of parent. This is not to say parents are unimportant, and in any society, the natural bond provides the best means of protection for growing children. Therefore, it would be wrong for the courts to ignore this relationship without good reason, but it would also be a mistake for any parent to believe that without this attachment, children will automatically suffer.